Hey everyone, my name is Sarah. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to do some spooky style lettering. Halloween is in 3 or 4 days, so I'm cutting it a little close, but to be quite honest, I like to do spooky or gothic style lettering all year round. I'm going to be doing four different styles. The pen and ink ones, I'm going to be using a ruling pen and a parallel pen. And then of course with Procreate, I'm just going to be using the Apple Pencil and trying two different styles. So if you're interested, just keep on watching, and if you have any questions while you're watching, don't hesitate to ask me in the comments below.
Okay, so to get started, I'm going to use a folded pen and this Ecoline ink. I like the Ecoline ink because it's very thin, so I get really easy flow with my pen. I have handmade folded pens, two different kinds. I'm going to use the resin one, the resin handle for this exercise, and I'm using this marker paper from Canson. It gives this really kind of bloody look with the splatters that come from the folded pen. And to get those splatters, you want to make sure that you're working on a hard surface. So if you have your piece of paper on top of a stack of papers, you may not get that same effect. So just make sure that you have more of a hard surface directly underneath the paper. I like to kind of map out what I'm going to draw before I go ahead and draw it. And yeah, I totally messed up that R, but whatever. And then I like to make my strokes pretty quickly so I can get more splatter. And sometimes I'll go up when you'd expect to go down just to get some different effects. And then I also try to really vary the thickness and the thin strokes just so it's not necessarily what you would expect, say if you were just using a regular nib pen. This one wasn't my best one out of I did try like a few times. You kind of just have to keep trying because it's a little unpredictable. So this one wasn't my best one, but it was the only one that my camera managed to record the whole thing for. So this is the one that you get to see. And to finish it off, I just take my pen and kind of throw it at the piece of paper so that I can get some more like blood splats to add to the final look. Also, I turned the volume down on all the pen scratches because I had music playing in the background, but honestly, sometimes it sounds like nails on a chalkboard. Okay, so this next one we're going to work on is a very classic gothic style using the parallel pen. It is by far my favorite. So I like to add guidelines for this style because it does need to be like all the same heights, and I also map out the shapes where my letters can fit in. Obviously, some shapes are wider and some shapes are narrow, so I take that into consideration. And to get this kind of gradient color, I actually have a red ink in this pen, and then in my other parallel pen, I have a black ink, and then I just touched the nibs together so that some of the black ink transfers to this pen. The goal with this pen is to make sure to keep your widths and your like strokes all the same. So you need to make sure that you're going straight up and down, and that the degree at which your pen is sitting, so I'm holding it in this specific angle, it needs to be held specifically that way throughout the whole piece. Otherwise, you're going to have some inconsistencies and it just will ruin the whole look. I did go in and added a little kind of effects, well, not effects, but like just little extra, not like swooshes, but like, I don't know what they're called, but I added them in the middle just because I like when the space is a little filled. And again, this one isn't my best either, but my camera didn't pick up my best one. Okay, so for the next one, I'm going to go into Procreate, and it's helpful if you have like a block letter to go with because, you're not going to use it exactly as is. You're going to kind of transform it, and it just kind of gets you there a lot faster. Also, block letters can be pretty tricky to create. Very time consuming, and you're not really going to be using it for what it is. So I suggest going to myfonts.com. I use this site a lot sometimes when I need some inspiration, and it took me a while to find what I was looking for. Eventually, I think I searched bold and skinny because I wanted a more narrow typeface that is on like the taller side but still has really good width to the strokes. So I did find one when I searched that term. So when I find it, I just click on the fit to width toggle, and then I screenshot it. And once the screenshot's ready, I crop it so that it just has the text showing. And then I take this into Procreate. And then from here, I'm able to reduce the opacity and then kind of trace over it. And then that will help me create my kind of, it's like a very like horror movie film effect. So both of the types I'm showing you on Procreate, you would kind of maybe see in an old horror movie poster. So to get this started, I just traced over the letters. Procreate is great for this because you can just draw a straight line and then make your boxes. And also you can save or copy and paste to another layer so that you can reuse some of the work that you've already done. So this word is pretty good because it has two O's and three R's. So once I've created one O and one R, I can just copy and paste those and I don't have to repeat all the work. This is a very tedious process, so if I can cut out steps, that's ideal. I do want to make sure that all of these are on individual layers because I do find that this font is a little more spaced out than what I need it for. So this way I can just move in all of the letters as I see fit if they're just all on separate layers. So that's kind of what I'm doing now, just separating them out and then making sure that it's all in the order of how the word is spelt. And then I'm just dragging them so that it's much closer because that is definitely the look of this like horror style lettering. Once I'm happy with that, I grouped it all together and then made a copy and then flattened that into one. I like to make copies because I like to keep the originals just in case. And now I'm just filling in all of my letters by dragging the fill color into the letterbox. So now I can reduce the opacity of the one I just drew out, and now I can kind of make it a little bit more horror-like. So this is really, really easy. Basically, I'm just kind of giving it a melted effect by drawing around the shape, but kind of doing it in like a wavy format and almost like a drippy format too. This one is not like a drippy, bloody text. It's more just kind of like wavy. And a lot of the times you will see this effect actually have more of a pointed bottom. So at the H, the two bottom, kind of, they're more squared off now, even though they are wavy. But there is a look where it does kind of come to more of a strong angle, like a point of a triangle. But for this one, I am just doing kind of a more regular wavy horror. I'm not really sure if they have a specific name. Okay, so to make this a little bit more exciting, I want to add a gradient. So I grabbed the medium brush from the airbrushing brushes in Procreate and a really cool lime green color and then just painted over the entire word. I then grabbed a little bit of a different shade of the lime green and just airbrushed on the top half. And then I decided to get an even lighter color and do like the top third just to give it even more depth. And now I want to add a shadow. So I duplicated the green word and then duplicated the black word. And then to get the shadow, I just dragged the green layer a little bit offset to the black layer, so it does create that shadow effect. And to take it up even more, I decided to add a stroke. So to start that, I duplicated the black layer and then moved it to the left so it creates that stroke naturally. Unfortunately, it doesn't create the stroke for all points of the letter, so I did go in manually to fill in any of the spots that didn't get the stroke and also clean up any of my mistakes from when I was painting over. It looks like it missed some spots. So just going through the black outline and making sure that everything looks even and consistent. And then once I was finished and happy with the way it looked, I wasn't super happy with the way it looked. I felt like the shadow was too close to the stroke, so I decided to just drag that shadow layer out even further so that the shadow was a little bit more noticeable. So now I'm happy with it, and we're going to move on to the next piece. It is inspired by an old horror movie film. I have all these inspirations in my pin board, so if you go to my Pinterest account, there's a board called Lettering Inspiration, and here I have this tarantula movie poster. So I've noticed that a lot of spooky kind of horror movie lettering has this like rough edge that kind of looks like it's been painted on with a paintbrush. So to start, I just made some guidelines so that I could get that kind of curved edge or curved line. And then I used a brush I found on Creative Market, and I'll link it below. So I'm just trying out the letters and testing out the brush. I did make sure to put these letters on a different layer for each letter because there is some shadowing that I want to add for the overlap of the different letters. So I'm just going to quickly do a little time lapse of going through the whole word. There is different effects with the pressure that you put on the Apple Pencil to the iPad. Depending on how hard you press will kind of change the effects of the brush. I didn't have enough room on the page, so I did have to put in a group and basically reduce the size. And after all, like after changing the size and whatnot, I wasn't super happy with the way that it turned out. I didn't like the way that it was balanced on the left versus the right. I found the letters on the left were a little bit larger than on the right. So I decided to try it again. I reduced the opacity and then just kind of went over and redid it. And I was happier with the second version. Okay, so now that I'm happy with my final letters, I am going to add some shadowing. So I basically just take the letter underneath and then erase some of the letter wherever it meets the letter on top, if that makes sense. And I just use the same brush that I used to create the letters as the eraser. But I realized I wanted to see the real shadow effect, so I made my background black and then painted the letters red. And then it kind of gives that more realistic, darker shadow underneath. And this is the color I wanted to end up with, so I decided to change it at that point. So very quickly, just going to also speed up this process. Basically, just going through each of the letters and creating that shadow so that they don't overlap as solid colors. This is the final end result, and I think it looks pretty cool. I really enjoyed this brush, and I think it gives a really close effect to the example I showed you in the movie poster. And just to kind of finish it off, I did add another gradient. I love the gradients. So I took an orange color and just kind of started painting the bottom of the letters. I basically duplicated that group and then flattened it. I don't know if there's an easier way that you can do this, but you can't paint a group. So that's what I did. I just kind of flattened it and then just added the gradient from the bottom. So it's super subtle, but I think it makes all the difference.
So I hope that was helpful. I would love to see if you try any of those styles, or I mean, I'm sure you may have before because they're not anything new, but for those of you who haven't tried them and learned a little something from these tutorials, I'd love it if you try it out and tag me on Instagram, because I would love to see them. And again, let me know if you have any questions, and if not, I hope to see you in the next video.